In this episode of Finno-Ugric Machining, as promised, we are going to make 6 precision pins. Well, in addition to those, we are making the non-concentric part, which is driving this whole thing. And if we are lucky, we will test drive the thing. So, pins first. Okay, here we are at the lathe, and this piece of material is cold rolled mild steel. And what I have already done is that, as you can see, here is a groove. This is to cut it off later on. I will turn it down to 10 millimeters, it's 12 at the moment. And then I will make a 9.05 smaller portion here. So, and I will film this in real time, so enjoy. doing a small sample here. Then just a sanity check. This should be quite exactly 10 millimeters, but you never know. Well, it's 200s under. Not a problem. And then back with the feet, and then we are making here 9.05 portion. And first I will measure it before I do the rest. This should be 9.05 and it's 200ths of a millimeter oversize at the moment. Yeah, and this should be quite accurate. So 200ths more. There you are. Yeah. And then quite exactly, yeah. Well, it couldn't be any better. It's exactly 9.05. And now some beautification here. Filing. There is a reminder of the people. For parting tool. I have a carriage stop which is in a place where I cut it. There is this nibble. Next step I will go to the bench grinder, and this is just, I will grind it away. Not a big deal. Like that. No more nibble. And then, phew! Hopefully this is in focus. Yes, it is. So here are already, as you can count, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 pins already. They are a little bit loose, some of them. This probably is also, yeah. And actually I will glue them. So now we only have one pin left. And yeah. It works. Really works. And it's a little bit tacky at some points because we are missing one pin. But when all the pins are there, it should be smooth all the way. And it's already, I can tell, this is going to work nicely. Okay. Here I'm drilling and tapping an M6 thread into the narrower end of this. The top plate for this pancake will be attached by 6 M6 bolts. And so first I spot drill it, and then I will use a 5mm drill about 2 centimeters depth. And I will do this for every piece, 6 of them, at first. So now, the next step will be to thread it tap, using a tap to thread it to M6. And I'm using an M6, this is a Dormer M6 spiral flute tap. It will rise the chips out from there. And pins here. Okay. This is one parallel, which is wrapped in this polyethylene film. So, because I don't want this parallel to become part of our our drive. And then we have those pins. One of those pins is a little bit tighter. It's this one. I will put it first there. But before that, I will have some glue into the holes. This is quite easy to do, I believe. Just put glue there. Like that. And then I have this small rod, which I use to spread it around there a little bit. Now, okay, then I put it here. And wipe this clean. And then we start with the tight pin. Oh man, a lot of that stuff. Let's put it into this hole, maybe. Okay, there it is. Down to the bottom. Next one. Next one. Next one. That was a little bit tight. And the last one. Yeah. Okay, now starting to make the eccentric. So, I'm not going to make the eccentric part here in the lathe. I'm going to do it in a milling machine with boring head. First I will turn this one so that it's good bearings fit with this surface here. And the hole here is 20 millimeters. This. And so this one should be a little bit smaller. So let's see, 19.97 probably. Surface is, of course, it's really nice. Now let's see where we are. I think we can take the rest with in one go. But so we are 20.39 seams. I hope you can see that. I think you can, actually. Now I check what we have there under. How much do we have left here? So it is 19.85, maybe 20.185, maybe. This hasn't an audience, so I cannot tell exactly, but it seems like we are there somewhere. So what we need to take from here now is, if I take 2/10 of a millimeter, we are quite near, but Well, let's do it in the old-fashioned way. So I take that and a little bit more. And then I don't go all the way through, I just go at the very beginning, a small portion at the end, and then I measure. And let's see what we have to do for the rest. That's enough. Did I say 97? We are there. So now I just do the rest with the same setting. So let's now measure it. Wow. And the surface finish is, of course, well, yeah. There you are. And now the final judgment. Judgment day is, of course, how this fits into there. It should be. It is. It's really good. It doesn't. It slips in, yeah, but it doesn't wiggle at all. You cannot feel anything there. So it's really, really nice. It's exactly what it should be. Here is the setup, how I centered this thing. So first of all, we have backings there. Those backings are protecting the surface and making this workpiece a little bit slippery in the jaws. I'm not using the dividing head as a rotating device. I'm using it just as a vise here to attach this piece somewhere. So what I have done, I have now dialed this surface here, this surface. The end here, so that when I rotate this, it's straight, and it is sitting straight there. And I didn't center it with the dividing head. I just ensured that the surface is it's straight. I have locked it actually now. I won't rotate it anymore. Then I have used this setup here. This. To go around, you probably know the how this is done. So when I go around here, like here, it's still like zero. And sorry, this is very hard to put on film. And there you are also in zero. And if you go under, it is also zero there. So now we know that the spindle of this this spindle is exactly on the center of this workpiece. Okay. Well, the next step is to put it aside a little bit and then board this. Okay. Well, next thing I will change here the wall halter. the wall halter is in place. I have adjusted the feed and speed. Speed will be about 400 revolutions per minute, and the feed is 17 millimeters per minute. So, well, it's rather slow. And then, now the next step is to move the table that direction. Our throw should be 0.95 millimeters. Well, half of that is 0.475. Wow. Is it? Yeah, it is. So if I put here 4.7, then we are quite near. So let's see now. And I, of course, I have eliminated the backslash here, so the move is valid here. So that was 0.2, 0.4, 42, 44, 46, and 47 is between the lines there. Ah, that should be it. Next, I will touch, and this I will do manually, by manually rotating this, and it should touch first this side. So I put it inside there, and this is really sorry, my head. It's really, really flimsy, this. Oh man. I should first loosen that one. So that's out. I think we are already there. Yeah, it's touching. I will do my first pass here. Let's put it. Let's take the backslash away from here. Let's put it on 30 here. No, not there on 30, but here. Oh, we can put it on 0 here. Hopefully that is not too much. Okay. Now, I run my first pass here. That's the feed. Well, you need to connect the gear. It helps. See what we did. You can watch it from this side. Oh well, nothing much. Okay, it's nothing much. Yeah, okay. So now let's have some more. Half a millimeter. There you are. And this is half a millimeter from diameter. Okay, lock that one and go again. Oh man. Let's take yet another half a millimeter from diameter, like that, and it's nice to have a boring head which has an accurate, this is really accurate, so Yeah, okay. Another half a millimeter. Let's not make it oversized, let's measure it first. But this is hard to measure as this is really... Okay. Huh. Well, that gave me a little bit less. 13.15. So half a millimeter more. This might clean up. It might clean up. Really, it might. Oh, let's see now. It's something like 60% clean. So now I can take a reliable measurement here, which is the actual diameter we are doing. Okay, now let's see where we are. Yeah, 13.60 seems. I'll measure it again. But if it is really 13.60, so we are safe here. It cleans up. Okay. Let's see if I get the same result. Please give me the correct figure. Yeah. It's 13.60. Yeah. I think this is 13.60. So, 13.60 is the actual diameter. So, not half a millimeter anymore. That would be oversize. So, I would like to be this to be real nice tight fit. So, maybe, because now I'm going to take the rest in one pass. So, it's if I take 40, then it's exactly. But I will leave there something like 200ths of a millimeter space. So, that's 10, 20. 30, that would be 40. And now if I, how much? Well, I'll put only 100, because nevertheless it should be somewhat tight there. But then we should be there, then this should be ready. And I really hope the rest should. It should actually clean up. And I have very good news. It's all the way clean. Good. And now if it's it should be 14 millimeters. Well, it is 14.1. Well, that would be really a real surprise for me.
14.1 would be, well, a real surprise. Well, oh man, it's 14.1. yeah, 14.1 and a half. So this is now down. Well, maybe I measure it again. It might be, but you cannot do anything about this after this. Really, it's what it is. You can with some, it's 14.1.
This is a 5 millimeter end mill. And I already, as you can probably see, I already plugged in once, 0.5 millimeter. And I will do this 0.5 millimeter at a time, until we are at 2.5 millimeter depth. Well, that should leave enough material on the side, etc. So, next 0.5 millimeter here. That's it. And as you remember, I did this one time before, and this type of milling is dangerous. it can grip. This is this material is something really, really bad. Okay, so let's start. I'm running this again 400 RPM. Maybe I should run it a little bit faster. Let's put some cruise control. 500. Let's go. Well, here is the piece. And next step, I will try it out in the... Did we mark the surface? Well, not badly. But it's probably... We need to do something. But the bore is really nice. It's... And the keyway is so well. I need to file it, and now you understand, when I now have a 5 millimeter rectangular file. So this is easy to do with that. A lot easier, because this guides my file in the correct place right away. And this material is not the easiest to file, but well. The workpiece is now in 20 millimeter collet. And I measured it, and we only need to take 0.1 millimeters to get it exactly the same thickness as the drive plate. But I will take yet another. So I will take 0.2 millimeters away from this. So that should ensure that it doesn't protrude the drive plate. So isn't proud from that. So what I will do now, I will actually just touch this surface. The carriage is locked, and I'm feeling a bit cold out going at this time. So I touch here. You know what almost happened? I have forgot to tighten the tool. It's always the same story. Ah.
0.2 millimeters away from that. Lock the compound. The feed is slowest possible. For bad surface. This surface is now it's a mirror. Oh man. Okay. And then I need to take care of that sharp corner. That's ready. Now just file the keyway. That's exciting. But first, I want to try it out in the motor. Oh, here we have some border. Well, easy enough to remove. Here it is now, and this is a makeshift key. It's a 3.5 millimeter drill just there, and I have oiled it, and of course I did already run it a little bit just to see whether it works or not. And guess what? It works. Let me start it. It really runs, and it's smooth, goes very evenly. No jumping around like with the previous one, and it's really powerful. You can stop it by hand from this gear. But just barely. It's really, yeah. And I know from experience that this will wear in first. And you can probably see the black stuff coming from the bronze bearing. This is because it wears in. Actually, it wears in. After a while it stops doing that. Same thing with the pins, with the six pins and their holes. There also is coming black stuff out. This stops when they are when they start liking each other, so to say. Thank you. Well, there is still something to do. The key? I cannot leave the drill into there. I have to make a real key for that one. And then I have to level those pins. They are on different heights. This is one thing I have to do. And then I have to make a cap at this end. It's a similar thing than the bottom one, but there is no gear present, no hole or anything. It just seals the whole thing and keeps this outer ring from wiggling. Well, yeah, and those operations will be in the next episode of Finnish Machining. Till then, bye!